Hi, my name is Tim Wyckoff. I'm a veteran, deployed twice to Iraq. After I got back, became a Charlotte firefighter. And since I've been on the fire department, I started a nonprofit organization called Veterans and First Responders Off-Road.
Tell me this, I saw it online.
All right.
I was born in San Diego, California. My dad was in the Navy at the time. I looked up to him. He was a single father raising me. So back in California, I got the idea to join the military, and I've wanted to join the military since then. Fast forward, we moved to North Carolina in the mid to late 90s, after my dad got out of the Navy, and I was raised out here in the small town of Union County, North Carolina. So at a very young age, I knew I wanted to be in the military, and I expressed that to my dad. My dad being in the military, growing up my whole life, dad always told me and was very upfront and honest with me, hey, this is where I messed up, so if you don't mess up, you'll have a very good life and a very good chance of doing the things you want to accomplish. So to back up a little bit, like I said, I knew I wanted to be in the military from a young age, so when I got into high school, I immediately joined ROTC in high school. So fast forward to 17 years old, I wasn't doing the greatest in school. I knew I wasn't going to college. I wasn't getting a full ride for wrestling or anything else like that. Army National Guard recruiter came to me and says, hey, we'll give you $10,000 if you join with us. And all my wisdom at 17, I said, okay. I took the paperwork, went to my dad. Dad giggled. He knew the kind of lessons I needed to learn, and that no matter how much he spoke and told me, I wasn't going to listen, so he was going to let me figure it out on my own. So he giggled, signed the paperwork, says, there you go, take off with it. After 4 years of ROTC, when you go into basic training, after you come out of basic training, you automatically come out as an E3. And then come out of basic training, come back home. Like I said, I was in the Army National Guard. So it's 1 week in a month, 2 weeks a year during the summer. But my home unit was already deployed in Iraq at the time. And a couple of months after I had been home, I got pulled to the High Point unit, 5th of the 130th, and I deployed with them. So my first deployment was from 05 to 06. We did a full boots on ground, full year deployment. Of course, after you get out back from deployment, you have post-deployment debriefings and everything else. Nobody really trains you for that. They throw you in, hey, how do you feel, this and that, oh, you'll be fine, you'll get over it, and boom, back into civilian.
Holy shit. Don't go any closer! I can't see anything! Keep doing what you're doing!
So fast forward a bunch, I've gotten on the fire department, I'm done and out of the military. So back in 2017, a buddy of mine from my first deployment called me up and says, hey, We're doing a guys only trip up to West Virginia to ride the Hatfield-McCoy Trail. And I didn't have a four wheeler at the time, but I grew up riding four wheelers, so I was like, all right, you know what? I'm gonna go buy one just for this trip. Up there, we had a blast. But one of the days after we had rode, we were sitting around the campfire, of course, having a few beers, whatnot, and we got to talking, and he reminded me of the first time we got blown up by an IED. And so me and him got to talking about that. Well, one of the other guys that was up there was a Desert Storm vet. So as me and my buddy were talking, we reminded the Desert Storm vet of some of his stories. The three of us were talking, two of the older guys were Vietnam vets, they heard us, and then they started chiming in with their stories. And from there, I've got the idea to, hey, we're not the only ones with these problems, we're not the only ones that need to talk. So from there, I got the idea to start a nonprofit organization where we take veterans and first responders on off-road adventures as a form of recreational therapy. And then at the end of the day, we'll be gathered around the bonfire and we'll just have natural conversations that come up between brothers and sisters who have been in similar situations and just let it out. So through that conversation, PTSD came up, and through all the research, no matter what other research you go through, PTSD is PTSD is PTSD. Doesn't matter how you got it, the symptoms are still the same, the effects are still the same. It's all still the same. We mostly focus on veterans and first responders because we have a very unique sense of humor that a lot of people don't understand sometimes, especially those who have not been in those situations. So my significant other, she's working on a sister group to our nonprofit organization. She talks and takes the rest of the family off, and they go and talk about their trauma, just because everything I've looked at in my own personal way of life, trauma attracts other trauma. And you'll see that trauma in somebody else and you'll be all like, I know what you're going through. I know that pain. I've been there. I can help you. And that's why a lot of times the family units, the significant others, also have trauma as well. So she's working on a sister group that will be coming soon, to where she will take the family members and they'll go talk about their trauma, even though it's different. As I said earlier, PTSD is PTSD is PTSD. Doesn't matter how you got it, the effects are still the same. So coming up this October 20th through the 23rd of 2023, we have our family trip in West Virginia. And the reason why we do a family trip is because no matter who in the family has the PTSD, it affects the entire family. And so this family trip is so other families can talk with each other, learn from each other, grow from each other. And somebody, say, like me, who's further along in our healing process, can talk with a family member or that family person who's just coming back or just going through it, just learning about it, can share our experiences with the other families and letting the other families know, hey, you're not alone in this. We've all been through it. We've been there. We've done it. Let me lead you to the way out, or to a way of better life. So if you're interested, you can go to our website, vnfoffroad.org, or you can go to our Facebook page, vnfoffroad at Facebook. And you'll see our event. It's scheduled in the events page on Facebook. It's also in our upcoming events on our website. Now, it's a blast. Like I said, we take you on off-road trips. You don't have to have a four-wheeler side-by-side. We have extras. We have four-seaters. We have multiple four-seaters. And also our members that come back all the time, they have four-seaters as well. We will find an empty seat for you to ride in if you don't have one. If you can't make it, we have, and you still want to support us, we have a Teespring website where you can buy merchandise that supports our cause. Also, you can donate PayPal. That's also on our website and our Facebook page. 100% of the proceeds go to supporting veterans and first responders. We don't take any of it. Nobody gets paid from this. This is all strictly volunteers. That way, 100% of the proceeds go straight into the organization and helping veterans and first responders.